Jackson, as we told you, everybody is happy with Kenya's performance in the Rio Olympics, but everyone is also disappointed with the mismanagement of the team in the Olympics. Keep talking to us. We are asking you, who do you think is to blame and who should be responsible for this and what should be done? In studio tonight, we're joined by Bernard Ouma. He's the coach, Athletics Club, Rongai Athletics Club. Thank you so much for making time for us. He has a personal story that he'll share with us shortly. And also via Skype from Eldoret, Moses Tanui. Nice to see him again after so many years. Of course, he's the 2-time Boston Marathon champion, was in the Olympics in 1988 and 92, world champion 1991, 10,000 meters in Japan, and of course the first man to run under 1 hour in the 1993 half marathon in Milan. He also has views about this. We'll be engaging him. Let me start with you first. There's been a lot of problems, mismanagement and everything. First, you are a coach to some of the athletes that went to Brazil, but you didn't go. If you are a coach, what happened?
Basically, Hussein, we have selected coaches which are supposed to travel with athletes, which still is not meeting the threshold, because you find it should be one coach to three athletes. In this case, we had close to 30 athletes, and we were given a slot of, I think, six coaches only, or maybe maximum 10, plus some other officials, this chaperone. But actual coaches who are working were very few. Then we have personal trainers and coaches. So there are two parallel accreditation when you are doing accreditation.
Right.
For the selected from the federation,
right,
and the personal coaches for the athlete, the elite athletes. Because you've got a rapport with them, you've got to be in constant communication with them.
Yeah,
and watching their performance.
Right.
This happens everywhere in the world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And some of these athletes, just to make it clear, is Elijah Manangoi, who's running the 1,500 meters, and you had Winnie Chebet, 800 meters.
Correct.
You coach these athletes.
Yes, I've nurtured and coached them.
So how is it that you didn't make it to Rio?
I was supposed to travel on the 14th. This is after arranging my own tickets from the athletes, personal ticket. I was told, no, we have issues of accreditation. Where you're going to stay is going to be an issue. So I got scared, so I pulled out.
This is Nock telling you can't go?
Yes.
Okay, and you're telling me you had arranged the travel with your athletes personally?
Yes, this was personal from
the
athletes.
Why not through Nock? Because it's done through Nock, isn't it?
You could not get proper communication from Soy, because all the time you make a call, you'll be referred to Soy.
Soy, for the viewers, Soy is the...
Soy was the chief commission for the team.
For the team?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And so that was the problem?
That was the problem.
Okay.
It was all about accreditation.
Okay.
And then we got scared midway. We wanted to take a risk, but we got scared midway when one of our legendary coach, Azra, Anzra...
Yeah. Didn't have accreditation.
Yes. And with some serious disorder mishap, and was exported
back.
Not sent back, it was exported back.
Exported back.
By way, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I read a few tweets here. Mario Collins says, the leadership of Athletics Kenya and NOC, as well as Ariel Wario, should have voluntarily resigned long time ago, like yesterday. We have focused athletes, this is Eric Ogi, and no one should be allowed to demoralize them. I don't know if this demoralizes the athletes you coach.
It's more than demoralizing. Demoralization is an understatement.
Did they speak to you after this?
Yeah, we keep on talking. Even now, I was talking to Manangoi. He's in Munich for treatment. I was talking with the doctor as well. They happen to be detached, and they happen to be... However, patriotism is very important. But we find a lot of gaps between... Should I be patriotic enough? Should I follow the coach's advice, or what do I do? So they're in sort of confusion state.
Who do you blame for this?
I'll blame the management. I blame the Ministry of Sports, the CS. However, it boils down to the National Federation to some extent. But you see, this was a NOC team.
So National Olympics Committee.
Yes, this is a National Olympics
Committee. That is where you think the problem is?
So far, that's where that problem originated. This was the first time. This is a chronic problem which is recurring. And
exactly.
I wonder why it was not stopped well in advance.
Earlier.
Yes.
Exactly. People have been saying that. Benson Itabari on Twitter, the entire management in sports ministry needs to be reviewed. They have failed terribly. Abdelmajid Mohammed on Twitter again says, NOC officials should do the honorable thing and step aside. They let the athletes and the country down. I don't know what you think. Moses Tanui now joining us via Skype live in Eldoret. You've been there. You've seen this. He said it. Everybody knows it. It's not the first time there have been these problems in major competitions that our athletes go to. Where do you think is the problem?
The problem, Hussein, is the management of what? When I was running, 1991, we even 44, which is 40. And the problem there are many, many here. Some people claim no good. You know, all the is being run who doesn't understand sports properly. And now it is time to go home and have new bid and let the wearer of the shoe to lead.
We seem to have network challenges, Moses. But you're saying it's time for who to go home, the NOC management, the leadership in NOC?
The leadership in NOC, the leadership in Athletic Kenya. Because if you see the American team or other teams,
yes,
especially when you have a coach, a personal coach, he or she must accompany an athlete.
Yes.
And this is where we go wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And I can say, if somebody who is leading doesn't understand what he's doing, you cannot take a doctor for people to treat cows,
mm-hmm,
or a veterinary.
Okay, we seem to have network challenges. We'll be trying to talk again to Moses Tanui, but he's saying it very clearly. There should be a change in Athletics Kenya, and especially NOC. Do you share the same views?
If I zero down to the issue at hand, which is the Olympics.
Yes.
I've got this is my own personal opinion, that Athletics Kenya, we were led into this trap, more so by allowing NOC to take over the selection of the team. That's one, two, which went to a laureate, which is perfectly well.
Okay.
Then secondly, by again, allowing NOC to dictate where the camp should be.
In Kenya.
They
okay.
ended up in Eldoret and some other. So it was scattered. So even the camping itself was not very neat as we are used to. I'm not saying it must be in Kasarani, but I'm feeling that AK was supposed to be fully involved.
Okay. Let me get this straight from you. You're
yes.
saying Athletics Kenya let NOC select the team. I thought each federation selects the people to go for the Olympics, and then they hand the list over to National Olympics Committee.
It should be like that one.
Yes.
But this one had a lot of arm twisting in this case. Yes, you are selecting your team, but we detect you what you're supposed to do. Take the
From
team
NOC.
To that venue. Yeah, this is NOC. The team has to, we have to do it in this venue, and the camp has to be into this venue. And not once I went to Athletics Kenya to question why are we having the camp in various locations. That even the athletes were complaining. I've got a first-hand information with athletes.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't like the camp going to Eldoret.
They did not like it?
Yes.
Okay, these are just some of the problems you saw. Coordinated travel, some like Ayimba of the Kenya Rugby Sevens team said they wanted to travel just a few days to the games, but it didn't happen. Issues of joyriders, again, you've talked about ANZRA, some of the coaches not getting accredited, and other issues that happened there. What are we saying? There's nothing that can be done to NOC because this has happened over so many years?
We've got a system which maybe is not working. I don't know whether the system is faulty, like the management of NOC was faulty in the Rio fiasco. And again, the back lies with the CS, Dr. Wario,
mm-hmm,
whom is being told to investigate himself.
Yeah.
And we are used to this. And the Kenyans, we've got a very sharp forgetting curve,
mm-hmm,
that an inquiry will be open. They will come up with their recommendations, and they will not be implemented. And good. Okay, we open another chapter. It happens from 1987, mm-hmm, when we had the All African Games in Kenya,
mm-hmm,
when one American went away with the money. The minister didn't do anything. It happened in 2011 in Maputo. It happened again in 2012
in London,
in the London Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
It happened in 2008. It happened last year as well. It's happening this year as well. So this is a chronic problem that we are there to live with.
Okay, the cabinet secretary you're talking about, Hassan
yeah.
Wario, said
yeah.
he himself is a victim of these cartels.
I don't
it's
think
like he really can do anything.
The buck stops with him. So how do you become a victim when you are in charge?
What can he do?
What
can he do? NOC keeps hiding under IOC. You can't really touch NOC because the International Olympics Committee will not allow you to.
You know, at times you might not take NOC as a federation, but
mm-hmm.
you need to, it boils down to individual
mm-hmm.
capacity. And in this case, it's only one person. The chief demission is responsible for everything. The legendary Kipchoge Keino, He's being smeared. A very nice. You saw how he was welcomed
in Brazil.
In Brazil.
Yes.
So you see, let's handle problems. If Hussein is responsible, own up to the responsibility, and step aside and let other people work for you.
That's who now.
If you want me to call names, I call the CS, and again I'll call the Chief de Mission of the Justice Department.
That is Zoe.
Correct.
Okay, Tanui, we have you back again via Skype, live from Eldoret. You were saying it's time to change what has been happening in NOC. He says, and some people have been saying, you know, the leadership should step aside. How do you handle NOC? We had the cabinet secretary saying he's a victim of the cartels in the National Olympics Committee, NOC. I mean, how do you handle it? It's been there for so long.
What I can say is that, you know, NOC comprises of many federations. Those federations should work hard and see that NOC send the NOC team to home. But you see, like, Athletic Kenya is part of NOC.
Yes.
And what I want to say about the selections of the team.
Yes.
You know, every federation select people to go to Olympics.
Yes.
And then NOC take care of all the teams.
Yes.
From other federations. So I want to blame, for example, in athletic, I want to blame Athletic Kenya for failing to send coaches for athletes. And it has been happening for many, many, many years. People are sending their friends. They don't even respect the athletes. And this is why we are saying as athletes at this moment that we need change. We need the government to support us because, you know, every federation is affiliated to international
Right, again, we seem to Okay, we seem to have again network challenges with Moses Tanui. Again, he's talking about change. You're talking about change. How do we achieve that? How is that going to happen?
You see, one is quite...
First, the people in NOC, the leadership, they are elected in office.
Correct.
How do you remove them? What can be done?
One is quite unfortunate that Athletics Kenya is not the biggest federation. Actually, the Athletics Kenya is Olympics. When you talk of Olympics in Kenya... is track and field, which is Athletics Kenya. We don't have any representation in NOC. Apparently, the leadership at NOC are a group of smaller federations, which are basically not calling the shots in terms of medal into the country. So, one, it is undoing for Athletics Kenya not to have a representation in NOC, because that played a lot during the management, when you don't have a voice, you don't have anybody to take care of your interests as well.
Yes.
But in terms of change, because we're having election next year, it's coming very soon, is upon the electorates, the delegates who are voting, to bring in people of integrity, people who can... I mean, this is a shame.
Right, but again, if you talk about the elections, they've been happening for the last 20 years, unless it's natural attrition, we haven't seen anybody really leave office.
Remember,
like they have their way to get elected again and again and again. That is why I keep asking this question, what really can be done? Because like Moses Tanui, and he's back again, we can talk to him. Like he said, during his time, this happened. We are talking about the same thing.
An inquiry. Those who are culpable, deny them the certificate of good conduct. That is it.
But do you think that's going to happen? Let me get Moses on this. Moses, do you think that is possible?
Well, Hussein, what I must say is that, especially Athletic Kenya, they compete, you know, Kiplagat and Okeo competed in NOC, and they were locked out. But what I want to say, and I want to categorically say, is that we need a new constitution. Kenyan constitution says the power is with the people. So we need that constitution to be changed, and we need so that we can have power as athletes, so that we can vote. Otherwise, you take somebody from the street and become and become the members of the federation. This has been done for many years, since 1950s. You know, those constitutions were done by the whites, by the colonial. So we need to change this constitution. so that it gives powers to the people,
yes,
to the athletes or sportsmen in this country, so that we lead and know what is the problem, because we need to wipe out and make sure that we have a new faces in all federation in this country.
Because if you go back to the same elections they've been doing, they'll still find their way like they have been doing, isn't it?
Of course, you know Section 2A in KANU. You remember KANU in Section 2A.
Yeah.
Now, we still have Section 2A in all the federations. So we need to remove that Section 2A and make sure that every athlete or every sportsman fought in all the federations. And yeah, that is why we have Mishap in North. We have everything run down.
There's a problem everywhere.
So yeah, they come from the streets.
Right. So, okay, you say they come from the streets. Okay, how do you suggest we go about, how you go about what you're saying, such a solution? Who starts it? Is it in Parliament? Do athletes meet and decide to do something? What happens?
What I want to say is I want all the athletes, we have one voice.
Mm-hmm.
So that when we talk one language, and then it is the athletes to change. Because sometimes all these federations are affiliated to international federations, and they have something that they say they don't need political
interference
in all mm-hmm. the sports.
Mm-hmm.
So we need athletes, and I'm adding all the athletes, either retired or active athletes, that we work together and we work for the new constitution. For our athletic federation.
That's one solution he's proposing. Moses, I don't know what you think about it.
I concur with him. Coach and athlete are very key, important people. Without coach, there's no athlete. Without athlete, there's no coach.
Mm-hmm.
The two make the federation, so these are managers.
Mm-hmm.
And I concur with him in terms of the constitution. And coaches, we had a meeting today. We had a lengthy meeting today.
Yeah.
And one of our agenda was the constitution, how coaches could be involved in this. So, yes, I agree with Tanu in that. We need to change the constitution. We have the Sports Act, which is guiding us in terms of the terms of the officials in the office.
Yes.
Yeah,
nobody is really following the Sports Act.
It should
again, nobody is following it.
I mean, it's offering a lot of solutions, what you're talking about now. So, yes, the constitution should be harmonized to favor the coaches and to favor the athletes as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you think, like Moses says, there should be a meeting of sorts to try and get everybody together and do a drastic thing to change all this?
Correct.
Okay. I'll read another tweet here. Ahmed Guhad on Twitter says, CS Warrior is held hostage by the NOC cartel. They are the elephant in the room. And then somebody else says, yes, we have massive 120 at Abel Nyarangi to improve at Akidogo. Killer time, nothing good in the news except for the medals, of course. Exactly, that's what you're saying. It was a good news for the medals, but you can see there have been problems and disappointments in how the team was mismanaged in the Rio Olympics game. Moses, I'll give you the final word now. You've said this is how we should go about it. I'm still trying to get how drastic that can be. Are you going to pioneer that, for example? Are you ready to do such a thing? Okay.
I can't hear you.
Yes, Moses, I'm saying you have suggested a solution here. It's so drastic, like we're saying, because you're saying we can't keep going back to the same thing and we'll have the same problems again. Are you willing to pioneer such a thing, what you said? Getting all athletes together.
Yes, Hussein, we need to move very fast. As athletes, we need to unite, we need to speak the one language and make sure that we stop this menace all the time. You remember, they removed Kiplagat from office, the same problem is there. So we need now that our solution is to make sure that we do the constitution and go for an election. Otherwise, this country will never, or those officials will never do something good for this country. So I'm saying I will pioneer and I will take the mantle and make sure that we change and change forever. So.
Okay, thank you very much. Moses Tanui joining us via Skype from Eldoret. Your final words on this.
I congratulate the athletes for the epic performance, for getting us the medal. But if things went straight and the coaches, enough coaches were sent to Rio, and the few selected were not humiliated and frustrated, we could have gotten more medals.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Lastly, I would like to condemn the strong about possible.
Yeah.
The frustration and the demeaning manner in which one of the legendary coach, John Ansra, was treated.
Right.
And as coaches, we were speaking at one voice and we were with John Ansra. We asking NOC to respect coaches, respect athletes as well. And we had a resolution today in the near future.
Yeah.
If we're having the same management at NOC,
yeah,
we're not going to allow athletes to go to competitions,
any competitions,
championships manned by NOC.
They're coming on Thursday. Is there any message you have for them? Is there anything you're going to do?
We did a press release, which is going to come tomorrow, and those are the resolutions.
Mm-hmm.
We are in consultation with the management of Athletics Kenya to come up with a proper last word
right
to them. But we are not amused. We are not happy with how our athletes that we really work hard for. And to make matters worse, we are not being given the opportunity to welcome them home. They're coming one by one. And some of them are organized their own transport back home.
Mm.
That tells you that...
And how did that happen? I've seen other nations, I don't know if it's individual, what they want, what individuals want, but I've seen other nations bringing...
I'll give
they're
you
all
an
coming
example.
Together.
You saw the UK today.
Yeah,
The same to Hungary. I studied in Hungary, I just came back a few weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
We sent a team there going for volleyball, and the airport was at standstill welcoming their team. What is so different with Kenya that seriously, we need to honor these athletes. We need to respect them as well. If they're really our ambassadors, we need to show them respect and cherish them. We find this is not unacceptable.
Yet this is the best we ever performed in the Olympics. In the Olympics game, and we didn't see them even actually, like you're saying, coming together so that we can celebrate them. Paradoma, who is the coach for the Athletics Club in Rongai, thank you so much for making time for us. And thank you, Moses Tanui, live via Skype from Eldoret. Thank you for your time tonight. Again, we ask you, what do you think? Where is the problem? Who should be held responsible? NOC, is that